Good morning, children. I'm going to continue the class now for the 6th standard science, and the lesson name is Force and Motion. So in the last class, what did we see? We saw about the rest and motion, and about the and now we are going to see about the contact and non-contact force in the detail now. Now in all the above cases, that is in the page number 20, children, those who have in the book, you can see in all the above cases the force is executed by touching the body. So these type of force is called as the contact force, that is touching the body. So contact force is nothing but the touching the body comes in, that is which comes in contact, that is called as a contact force. Now mysteriously ripened coconut falls to the ground. Ripened means palutha idu solranga, coconut falls to the ground. What pulls it to the ground? So namma vandha adu poi irukkradilla, adu poi edukkradilla, but it automatically falls on the ground. So how did it falls? What pulls it to the ground? We would have heard the force of gravity of the earth, force of puvi irpen solranga, force of gravity of the earth. So earth has some type of gravity which pulls it, okay, force of gravity of the earth. So by the force of gravity the coconut falls down on the ground. Now gravity pulls a ripened coconut from the tree to the ground. So how does it fall? By the gravity. Gravity pulls a coconut, that is ripened coconut, from the tree to the ground. Now next is a this is a contact force, okay. Next, bring a magnet near the small iron nail. For example, if you take a magnet, you see then nails are here. What happens if you take closer to it? The nails go and jump and go and touches it near. So near the small iron nail, suddenly the nail jumps into the air and sticks with the magnet. What happens, sir? Nails jump in the air, and where does it go? It sticks to the magnet. Now observe that the magnet and the nail did not touch each other. So namma observe panni paathona the rendu me na vandu touch pannala, but what happens, it jumps in the air and go and touches the magnet. So still there was a pulling force that made the nail to jump towards the magnet. There was a pulling force that made the nail to jump towards a magnet, that is it has some attraction which pulls the nails towards a magnet. So in these two examples, what did we saw? The force is applied without touching the object, that is without touching the object, that is called as a non-contact force, that is called as a non-contact force. So what is that, children? Contact force and non-contact force. For example, touching the body, I said that is a contact force, and non-touching the body, we saw two types, that is force of gravity and the attraction of the magnet. Now forces can be classified into two major types, that is contact as well as a non-contact force. I already said to you all. Then wind, for example, that is wind is making a flag flutter. Flutter na kaathula parakkuradhu illaya, wind na kaathu, flag is fluttering in the wind. A cart pulled by a bullock are the contact force, that is we are pulling cart irukkilla maattu vandi irukla, that is a contact force. And magnetism, gravity are the examples of the non-contact force. So these are the two examples given for the contact as well as a non-contact force. So see here, that is force is given here. So agencies, then types. So agencies is animate, inanimate, and types is the contact force and non-contact force. So these are the types and agencies of the forces. Now what happens when we apply a force on an object? For example, what happens when you apply a force on an object? Say you push a book on the table, the book moves. So the application of force on an object, that is object means book, we are putting the force on the object, results in a motion from a state of rest. So when you are putting the force on the object, what happens? The object which is in rest moves, that is comes into motion. Then what happens when a batsman hit a ball? So batsman ball adikkarar illaya, the ball is ready in motion. Adhaavadhu the ball is swinging the ball, the batsman is hitting a ball. So the bowler enna pannara, first vandu ball thooki podraar illaya, so ball is ready in motion but with the strike, avan vandu bat ala adikkum bodhu enna agudhu, the ball oda speed innum jaasthi aagum illaya. So the speed of the ball increases. Moreover, the direction of the ball also changes. So adikkum bodhu ore side la pogada, endha side la apdiye mari mari pogum direction illaya. So the direction also changes. So application of the object, force on the object results in the speed as well as the direction. And so illaya, that is the ball is ready in motion but when strike it, the ball speed of the ball increases and the direction also changes. So there is a change in the speed as well as in the direction, change in the speed and change in direction. Okay children, so for example crush a ball, namma balloon vandha enna panna crush pandrom. What happens? Apply a force on roti dough, dough na maavu. So pull a rubber band, when you pull a rubber band, these are the examples. In this case the shape of the object change on application of force. Now application of force in the object results in the expansion or contraction. Okay, next look at this picture here. When you see here, the person is applying a force to stop the cart from moving. Bullock cart irukku illaya, maattu vandi, what he is doing is putting a force to stop the cart from moving. So nama stop panna adu enna agum, rest la varum illaya. So when the force is applied against the direction of the motion, adhaavadhu nama ilukkuradhu enadhu opposite side illaya. So thadrathu vandha namak nama straight direction da, nama vandha adu ilukkum bodhu enna agudhu, it is in the opposite direction. So direction of the motion, the speed can be reduced na kami panna mudiyum, the speed can be reduced or even the motion stopped completely. One we can reduce or it can be stopped completely. Then discuss what happens when you apply brake in a speeding bicycle. They have asked. Next, the applied force is an interaction of an object on another that causes a second object to move from rest, speed, slow down, stop, change the direction. Now forces they have asked, that is what are the changes here? Changes the states of body from rest to motion or motion to rest. Rest la irukkuradhu move pannalam, moving la irukkuradhu rest la kondu varalam. So these are the changes in the states of the body. Next, either change the speed or direction or both of the body. Next, what you are going to do? You are going to change the speed or change the direction or both of the body. Next, change the shape of the body. So these are the changes, that is first what I said, change in the states, that is from rest to motion or from motion to rest. Next, change in the speed or direction or both also you can say. Next, it also changes the shape of the body. So these are the changes. Now next is the, they have asked, force can, in that there was three. Okay, so first is a, they have given in the first box move from rest, and another box also they have given change the speed, and here they have given compress or expand. Now first they have asked move from rest, that is move to rest. So next what will come? Rest from move, that is rest to move. So this is the first. Then next is the change the shape. What are the changes I said children? Change the shape as well as change the speed already given here. So next is a change the direction. Okay, so these you can fill the boxes, children. So this one and this. Next you have given forces, contact force and non-contact force. You have to give examples for this. So already I have learned the examples for this. First, already they have given kick a football. So next, what we can give? Man stopped a bullock cart. Stopped a bullock cart. That is a contact force. Okay. So next, in the non-contact, we saw first they have already given magnet attracts nail. So magnet, as magnetism as well as a gravity also comes in the non-contact force. That is coconut falls on the ground. Coconut falls on the ground. That is first, already they have given first example about the magnet. Next they have asked, that is you can give about the gravity. Now next is the types of motion. So next we are going to see the types of motion. In that, Shanti took a pencil and sharpened it with a sharpener. Then she drew a, first she sharpened it with the sharpener, first picture. Then the next picture is, she drew a circle using a pencil and a compass. What did she do? She drew a circle with a compass using the pencil also. Then later she took a ruler, that is scale, and drew a straight line in another paper. So first what she did, she drew, sharpened the sharpener. Next, that is, she drew a circle along with using the pencil and a compass. Next, she used a ruler which she drew on in another paper. Next, then she kept the pencil between her finger and she moved it back and forth. இப்படி ஆட்டிட்டு இருந்தா சரியா. Now first, in that case, in the first case what happens, a pencil sharp பண்ணும்போது என்ன ஆகுது, சுத்துது இல்லையா, that is rotates on its axis. That is in the first case, rotates on its axis. Then in the next second case, that is she is drawing a circle, that is she went in a circle. Okay, this is the second case. And in the third case what happens, a pencil traveled in a straight line, that is she draw a line, that is straight line. And in the last, that is in the fourth case, what happens, a pencil tip moved back and forth, that is oscillation, like oscillation of a swing. நம்ம ஊஞ்சல் ஆடுறோம் இல்லையா, முன்னாடி போயிட்டு பின்னாடி வருது, அந்த மாதிரி பேக் அண்ட் ஃபோர்த், தட் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆஸ் எ ஆசிலேஷன். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த ஃபோர் கேசஸ் ஆஃப் த மோஷன், தட் இஸ் ரொட்டேட்டிங், சர்க்கிள், ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் அண்ட் ஆசிலேஷன். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் மோஷன். நவ் தட் இஸ் த மோஷன் வாஸ் ரொட்டேஷ்னல் அண்ட் தட் சர்க்குலர், நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன் அண்ட் தென் ஆசிலேட்ரி. ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த மோஷன் வி சா. தென் இட் ஃபார் அனதர் ஒன் இஸ், த்ரோ பேப்பர் ஏரோப்ளேன்ஸ் ஆர் பேப்பர் டாட், அதாவது நம்ம பேப்பர் ஏரோப்ளேன் செஞ்சு நம்ம போடுவோம் இல்லையா, நம்ம தூக்கி போடுவோம். அப்போ வந்து என்ன ஆகுது, வாட்ச் இட்ஸ் ஃப்ளைட் பாத் வென் யூ த்ரோ இட் அட் அன் ஆங்கிள், அதாவது நம்ம ஒரே போன ஒரே ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைனில் போகாது, அப்படியே சுற்றி பறந்து போய் எங்கேயாவது விடும் இல்லையா. ஸோ த பாத் கர்வ்ஸ், தட் இஸ் அ பேப்பர் ஃப்ளைட் இஸ் மூவிங் அ ஹெட் பட் டைரக்ஷன் இஸ் சேஞ்சிங். ஓகே, நம்ம மேலே தூக்கி போடுறோம், பட் என்ன ஆகுது, ஒரே டைரக்ஷனில் போதா கிடையாது, த டைரக்ஷன் இஸ் சேஞ்சிங். With while moving, such parts are called curvilinear. That is called as a curvilinear. That is ore direction la pogama suthi porudhu seriya, that is curving linear. Then a flying buzzing around the room is a combination of all these, and flight path is zigzag. Okay, so that is called as a zigzag motion. Now you can classify the motion according to the path taken by the object. For example, first I said straight or otherwise called as a linear motion. So straight or otherwise called as a linear motion, that is moving in a straight line. Already I said that girl is drawing a line, straight line, that is linear. Okay, so moving in a straight line and like a person walking in a straight path. புரியுதா, ரோட்ல நம்ம போறோம் இல்லையா, ஸ்ட்ரெயிட்டா போறோம். Then free fall. So these are the linear motion. Next is curvilinear. So next is a curvilinear, moving ahead but changing the direction. நம்ம மேலே போகும் பட் என்ன ஆகும், டைரக்ஷன் சேஞ்ச் ஆகும். லைக் அ த்ரோயிங் பால், ஸோ நம்ம மேலே வந்து போடுறோம் பால், அப்போ என்ன ஆகுது, டைரக்ஷன் சேஞ்ச் ஆகுது இல்லையா, தட் இஸ் அ கர்விலீனியர். தென் சர்க்குலர், தட் இஸ் சர்க்கிள் ஐ செட். தென் மூவிங் இன் அ சர்க்கிள், ஸ்வர்லிங் ஸ்டோன் டைட் டு த ரோப், அதாவது ஒரு ரோப்பில் kalla suthi enna pandrom sutrom illaya that is that also swings in a circle then rotatory the movement of a body about its own axis like a rotating top top na bumper irukku illaya adu eppadi nama ponum bodhu eppadi sutrom that is rotating then oscillatory that is coming back to the same position after a fixed time interval like a pendulum adhaadu nama wall clock irukku illaya the wall clock la pendulum irukku adu eppadi move aagum that is moving back and forth illa so like that come back to the same position adhaadu enna aagum ipdi poiittu thirupi adoda same position ku adu varum illaya that is a oscillation like a pendulum the next is a zigzag zigzag is nothing but the irregular irregular motion okay so like the motion of a bee or people walking in a crowded street crowd na romba full ah irupanga la nariya per irupanga so and the crowd la enga yaar yaar nippanga na namak theriyadu apdi irukku so crowded street that is called as a zigzag or the irregular now down they have given children so listen ya fast oscillations so that oscillation vandu nalla fast ah pogum bodhu they are referred to as vibrations okay fast oscillations are also called as a vibrations next first you are given the activity down here tell me what type of motion I am watching the path of my motion so first what they have asked one line they have given that is straight okay that is nothing but the linear motion what motion is that linear or straight motion next it's going above our head but changes the direction that is a curvy linear next is a circle okay that is circular next is a next it's going like this yeah that is in the zigzag next is a zigzag then next is a moving from one form to a coming back to its own position that is called as a oscillatory okay these are the five types of motion they have asked then periodic and non periodic motions that is for example if you take the case of your hour and of a clock that is you are taking a clock now in one day it makes two rounds that is morning 12 o'clock and night 12 o'clock okay that is two rounds it's moving then it bounces a certain number of times for a given time interval or period now for example if you take a water vase in a given period what happens the time interval fixed number of waves hit the shore waves na ala solrallaya adu vandha enna avu vandu vandu and the shore vandu tottittu pogum illa so a fixed number of waves hit the shore so these are the motions repeated times adu vandu ore or thara vandu ninnidadu adu vandite irukku repeated ah vandirukum illaya so motion repeated in equal intervals of time is called periodic motion motion repeated in equal intervals of time equal intervals of time is called periodic motion okay now that is the motion which is not in uniform interval adavadhu equal ah in equal intervals of time irukadhu periodic which is not uniform that is called as a non periodic adavadhu nama calculate panna mudiyadhu seriya non periodic time periodic na nama equal intervals la we can calculate how many times it's repeated but idu vandu non periodic vandu it's non uniform interval that is that cannot be calculated that is called as a non periodic motion then devas do you notice that all oscillatory motions are periodic but not all periodic are oscillatory that is revolution of the moon moon sutti varudhilla around the earth is periodic but not oscillatory adavadhu nama moon vandu earth rounda sutite irukum thirupi adu return la varadhu illaya so oscillatory ingirathu it's moving to one side and again coming back to its original position but rotating of the revolution of the moon is not oscillatory but periodic adavadhu sutite irukum ana adu enna varadhu oscillatory ah irukadhu then next however the children playing in a swing adavadhu oonjalla is both periodic as well as a oscillatory now fast versus slow now look at the tall tree when the wind is gentle adavadhu kaatu vandu light ah adikkum bodhu its branches are dancing slowly adavadhu branches vandu slow ah move aagum But if the gentle wind becomes strong, அது இன்னும் வந்து அந்த ஜென்டில் விண்ட் வந்து இந்த காற்று ரொம்ப ஸ்ட்ராங்காக அடிக்கும் போது என்னாகும், த பிரான்ச்சஸ் ஷேக் வைலண்ட்லி, அதாவது பிரான்ச்சஸ் வந்து ரொம்ப அதோட அசை வந்து ஜாஸ்தியாக இருக்கும். அண்ட் இஃப் த ஸ்பீட் இன்க்ரீசஸ், இன்னும் அதோட ஸ்பீட் இன்க்ரீஸ் ஆகும்போது த பிரான்ச் இவன் பிரேக் அண்ட் ஃபால். புரியுதா? தட் இஸ் த மோஷன் கேன் பி ஸ்லோ ஆர் ஃபாஸ்ட். ஸோ வாட் டிட் ஐ சேட், இஃப் யூ டேக் அ டால் ட்ரீ வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வென் த விண்ட் ப்ளோஸ் ஜென்ட்லி அதோட பிரான்ச்சஸ் வந்து என்ன ஆகும், டான்ஸ் ஸ்லோலி. பட் இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் வந்து அந்த விண்டோட இது வந்து இன்க்ரீஸ் ஆகும்போது என்ன ஆகும், அந்த பிரான்ச்சஸ் எல்லாம் வயலண்ட்டாக ஷேக் ஆகும். பட் இஃப் இட் இன்க்ரீசஸ் ஃபர்தர் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ், இவன் த பிரான்ச்சஸ் கேன் பிரேக் அண்ட் ஃபால் டவுன். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ ஃபாஸ்ட் வர்சஸ் ஸ்லோ. தென் கம்பேர்ட் டு வாக்கிங், சைக்கிளிங் இஸ் ஃபாஸ்ட். ஓகே, நம்ம நடந்து போகிறோம், நடந்து போகிறதுக்கும் சைக்கிளில் போகிறதுக்கும் எப்படி இருக்குது வித்தியாசம், சைக்கிளில் போகிறது தான் நமக்கு வந்து ஃபாஸ்ட்டாக தெரியும் இல்லையா. சேமே த ஏரோப்ளேன் இஸ் மச் ஃபாஸ்டர் தேன் அ பஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ பஸ்ஸில் போகிறதுக்கும் எப்படி, ஏரோப்ளேனில் பஸ்ஸில் வந்து நம்ம ஸ்லோவாக தான் போகும், ஆனால் ஏரோப்ளேனில் வந்து நம்ம சீக்கிரமாக போயிடலாம் இல்லையா. ஸோ ஸ்லோ ஆர் ஃபாஸ்ட் இஸ் அ ரிலேட்டிவ் கான்செப்ட் விச் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் அப்பான் த மோஷன்ஸ் வி ஆர் கம்பேரிங். தென் see here, they have given average speed. I have traveled 160 kilometers in 2 hours, the bus driver is saying, and that is taxi driver is saying, and the bus driver says I have traveled 200 kilometers in 4 hours, and the truck driver is saying I have traveled 300 kilometers in 5 hours. Now can you say who traveled with high speed? That is, then how do we say a body moves in a particular space? For example, average speed is equal to distance by time. Okay, so average speed is equal to distance by time. Okay, distance by time, this is a formula. Now for example, distance traveled by the car in 1 hour, they have given, that is 80 kilometers, that is car. Okay, that is 160 divided by 2. So see here, for this they have given, that is 160 divided by 2 means 2 8s are 16, that is 80 kilometers. Next they have asked, distance traveled by the bus, that is distance traveled by the bus in 1 hour is 200, then 1 hour they have asked, that is he traveled in 4 hours 200 kilometers. Okay, in 4 hours, this is a distance divided by time. Now we are going to see in 1 hour how much, so 200 divided by 4, that is 4. That is 50. Okay, so the answer is 50 kilometers. Next, distance traveled by the truck in 5 hours, they have asked, that is how many, 300. Truck is 300 in 5 hours. So 300 divided by 5 is 560. So in 1 hour, how much? 60 kilometers. So this is a car, and this is a bus, and this is a truck. Okay. So car is 80 kilometers, bus is 50 kilometers, and truck is 60 kilometers. They have traveled in 1 hour. Now they have asked, have you find out, say now, which is the fastest and which is the slowest? So fastest here, which is the fastest here? 80. So car is the fastest, and which is the slowest? That is the bus. Okay, so faster is the car and slowest is the bus. Okay children, now have you noticed that saying who is fast and slow is easy when we calculate the distance it traveled in 1 hour. நம்ம 4 hours 5 hours வச்சு பார்க்குறது, அந்த 1 hour-ல நமக்கு கண்டுபிடிக்கும் போது அது நமக்கு ஈஸியாக இருக்குது. தென் சி ஆர் த ஃபார்முலா கிவன் யா, த டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ட்ராவல் பை அன் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இன் யூனிட் டைம் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆவரேஜ் ஸ்பீட் ஆஃப் த ஆப்ஜெக்ட். நவ் இஃப் அன் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் ட்ராவல் அ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இன் டைம் தட் இஸ் ஐ செட் தட் இஸ் ஆவரேஜ் ஸ்பீட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டிஸ்டன்ஸ் டிவைடட் பை டைம். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ ஃபார்முலா. ஓகே சில்ட்ரன், ஓகே சார். ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் ஹாஃப் வில் சீ இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் சில்ட்ரன். தேங்க்யூ.